The following is a special presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
They touch, they run, going down the backstretch, side by side, wheel to wheel. They touch, coming down through the triangle, at the line. Who wins it? Come
on, bring her inside, Dale. Don't let him get down there. He's going to make it. Dale Jarrett's going to win the Daytona 500.
A very popular driver takes the four through corner number four. He comes onto the main straightaway. And Dale Jarrett wins the Brickyard 400 for the second time.
This is better than I ever imagined. I mean, you know, you can dream about this and you can think what it would be like. This is something that you wish that every competitor out here would have the opportunity to experience.
We're proud of you for what you've accomplished this year. And just thanks so much for the type of person you are and what you do for the family and the community and all of that. What you do on the racetrack is a bonus, buddy. Enjoy it.
Thanks, Dad.
For the 10th consecutive year to the Grand Ballroom of one of the most spectacular hotels in all the world, the Waldorf Astoria in New York City, for tonight's coverage of the NASCAR Winston Cup Series Awards Banquet. Hello, everyone. I'm Jerry Punch, and we are so glad you could join us on this most festive of evenings. You know, 1 year ago tonight, we came here to put a period on NASCAR's 50th anniversary celebration and to pay tribute to the vision of William Henry Getty France and his family that had the courage to chase their dream some five decades ago. And ironically tonight, in this the final championship awards banquet of the century, we once again honor a dreamer, a young man whose desire it was to follow in his famous father's footsteps, and tonight, that dream becomes a reality. Now, we cannot talk about our NASCAR family without mentioning some who aren't here tonight, like our third place finisher in points, Mark Martin, who will join us by the magic of television a little later on. But actually, Mark is recovering from back surgery at his home in Daytona Beach, Florida. Mark, we know that you and Arlene and Matt are watching. Get well soon. And our Bob Jenkins, after a brief hospital stay, is recovering in his home in Indianapolis from an illness. Bob, we know that you and Pam are watching. We miss you, buddy. Hurry back. Now, I am joined by Benny Parsons and Bill Weber. And Benny, this is a huge night, a big night in the Big Apple for big money.
And we know that Big Bill France certainly had some dreams with his sons, Billy and Jimmy, dreams of a racing organization that would be known worldwide, of high bank speedways with a seat over 100,000 people. Took a little while, but by the early 90s, their dreams became reality. Now, most race car drivers' dreams of victories and championships are able to attain that by their age of 30. But like the France family, it took the 42-year-old Dale Jarrett a little longer.
And I think there's a message there, and that's the message Dale Jarrett wants to deliver over the next 12 months. As Jerry said, this is a big night in a big city, but a week ago it was a big night in a small town, his hometown of Hickory, North Carolina, where Dale Jarrett was the guest of honor at an intimate reception for family and close friends. He told that gathering that in each interview conducted since he won the title, he's tried to make the point that his championship should serve as motivation to everyone that's chasing a dream, no matter what their age currently is. Yes, you will run into roadblocks, and you will run into people that say, you can't do it. Well, Dale Jarrett drove through those roadblocks and around the people that said he couldn't do it, and he got it done. Now, this is always an exciting and emotional evening in New York City, but I think before this special night is over, everyone in this room and everyone watching on television will not only see how much this championship means to Dale Jarrett and his entire crew, but everyone will feel it as well. It is true emotion that comes straight from the heart.
And Bill, that conjures up visions of those inspirational words from our great friend, the late Jim Valvano, who said, "Don't give up. Don't ever give up." And indeed, Dale Jarrett didn't. Now, your onstage host tonight is no stranger to anyone in sports. He is both a friend and fan of NASCAR, and I'm proud to say he is my colleague on our Thursday night primetime college football telecast. Please welcome once again Mike Tirico.
Thank you, Jerry. Thank you, everyone. Good evening. Nice to be with you, Jerry, and the rest of our ESPN friends. You know, getting to the stage of the Waldorf Astoria as the NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion on this the first Friday in December, it takes stamina, the stamina of a marathon runner who must train and compete for an endurance run on an almost weekly basis. But unlike the marathon runner who trains and competes almost in solitude, Getting to this stage takes the efforts of a dedicated and proficient team. Tonight, 9 other drivers will also take this very stage and collect the rewards they are due. They also worked hard, they trained hard, and they had the support of their great crews. They led laps, often beat 40 other talented drivers off of pit road, and won many, many races. But only one of the group will lay claim to the top prize, a prize that is awarded for just flat-out consistency. So, Doc Punch, in the next couple of hours, we're going to crown a new champion, a man who's been on this stage several times before, but tonight emerges as the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion, the last champion of this century.
Thank you, Mike. When we return, we'll be set to kick off NASCAR's big night here in the Big Apple. So stay with us.
The 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards Banquet is being brought to you by The Home Depot. The Home Depot would like to congratulate Tony Stewart, 1999 NASCAR Rookie of the Year, by Haviland Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car. And by Napa Auto Parts. We keep America running.
Welcome back to the Waldorf Astoria. Now let's begin the evening's festivities. Once again, here's your host, Mike Tirico.
Okay, Jerry, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, now time to recognize the 2nd through 10th place drivers from the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup standings. And to do that, would you please welcome the president of Sports Marketing Enterprises, R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, Mr. Rick Sanders. Rick?
Thank you, Mike, and good evening. The NASCAR Winston Cup Point Fund was established back in 1971 with a very simple goal in mind, and that was to recognize and reward those drivers and teams who not only performed, but performed consistently throughout the year. Now, 1999 proved to be a remarkable year for consistency, and it's my pleasure tonight, on behalf of R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company and the Winston brand, to introduce you to those drivers who captured positions 10 through 2 in this year's point standings. So let's begin. Taking 10th place in 1999, driver of the number 31 Lowe's Home Improvement Warehouse Chevrolet Monte Carlo, Mike Skinner.
1995 NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series Champion and 1997 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Rookie of the Year, Mike Skinner, had plenty to smile about in 1999, breaking into the top 10 in points for the first time in his NASCAR Winston Cup career. Skinner led the point standings for 3 races early in the season, and then later on earned a pair of Bud Poles, leading the field to the green at Pocono for the Pennsylvania 500 and at Richmond for the Exide NASCAR Select Batteries 400. The California native posted a total of 14 top 10 finishes, his best being a 3rd at the UAW GM Quality 500 at the Lowe's Motor Speedway. Twice eligible for the Winston No Bull 5 bonus, the teammate of the Intimidator proved on many occasions that he knows how to get to the front and that a NASCAR Winston Cup win is well within his grasp. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the driver of the Richard Childress Racing Lowe's Chevrolet, 10th place in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series point standings, Mike Skinner.
Mike, it's hard to believe that only 2 years ago, you were the Rookie of the Year in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series. And here you are breaking into the top 10 in only your 3rd season. Congratulations from NASCAR and from Winston. I've got a check here in the amount of $214,556.
Wow. This is pretty cool. When I was here in 1997 to pick up the Rookie of the Year award, I couldn't even see the table back there where the people were sitting that made all this possible. Dale Pond, Tom Whidden, Dean Kessel of Lowe's Home Improvement Warehouse. I'd really like to thank Bob Tillman and Larry Stone, Bob Kerfeller, and all the 80,000 Lowe's employees across the country for your support. Thanks also to everybody at MTD and Valspar, Georgia Pacific, Owens Corning, and Cobalt Mechanics Tools. And a special thanks to everybody at NASCAR and RJ Reynolds for their support. You know, it's like we're coming from the outhouse headed toward the penthouse. There's the penthouse right there. Congratulations, Dale, Todd, Robert, Carolyn. All you guys at Robert Yates Racing, you guys did an awesome job this year. Just congratulations. You know, racing's a funny thing. Just when you think everything's falling to pieces and the car's not running well, you're afraid you're gonna lose your crew chief, then suddenly you can turn a corner and things start to go the other way. That's kind of what happened to us. We got Larry McReynolds, in my opinion, the best crew chief in NASCAR for the next 3 years. And Lowe's agreed to sponsor our race team for another 3 years. And then to make things even better, Chevy made great race cars and Goodyear gave us outstanding tires. Everything started to come together. But during the rough times, someone who's been a great source of inspiration to me is Dale Jarrett. A few years ago, Dale changed rides. Things looked pretty tough for you for a while. But you're the champion now. That's pretty awesome. That's gives me some hope, buddy. But our team's plans are to change places with you someday. So that's what our goals are. There are other people in my life who not only help me to day-to-day stuff, but make being up here worth all the hard work. And it's my managers, my girlfriend Angela, my brother Jim. Thank you guys for your daily support and encouragement. You're awesome. Thank you. My sons, Dustin and Jamie, mean the world to me. Jamie's turning out to be a great racer. He had a solid year this year in late model season, and even a few Busch Series starts. And Dustin won 6 of his 8 four-wheeler races this year, so the real driver might yet to be coming here. Might see him in the future. The success of the number 31 car had this year was a group effort from help from the team owners, Richard and Judy Childress, to Larry McReynolds, team manager David Smith, shop foreman John Livensberger, Bill Patterson, Lenny Baticki, everybody at RCR, our PR team, all the guys in the engine shop and the fab shop, the entire Richard Childress racing staff, including my teammate Dale Earnhardt. Thank you. I would love to mention each member of the 31 team by name, but I don't have that much time up here tonight, so unfortunately, I can't do that. So what I'd like to do is tell the guys back at the shop that I'm just up here representing them. This is all for them. They're the ones that make all this worthwhile. They're the ones that did all the hard work, the guys that went over the wall. Pretty awesome. I just want to thank you guys. You guys are awesome. I'd like to also send a get well wish to a really tough guy that we all know, Mark Martin, who's recovering from back surgery. Really look forward to racing with you next year, Mark. Get well quick. Love to see you here tonight. And of course, I want to thank all the great NASCAR fans. It's an honor just to be able to compete for you each and every week. It's pretty awesome. We're excited, looking forward ahead to 2000. We're going to put in a lot of hard work, build on the success that we had this year, learn a lot from our mistakes. And the good Lord willing, some big things are going to happen. Like I said, we're going from the outhouse to the penthouse. I'm looking forward to the year 2000. It's going to be a great year for us. Thank you.
Capturing 9th position in this year's point standings, driver of the number 22 Caterpillar Pontiac Grand Prix, Ward Burton.
Ward Burton gassed it up this season, finishing in the top 10 of the NASCAR Winston Cup Series point standings for the first time in his 6-year career.
the Catman garnered the butt pole for the Pepsi 400 in Michigan, started from the front row at Darlington for the Pepsi Southern 500, and was twice eligible for the Winston No Bull 5 bonus. Ward racked up three runner-up finishes in a most unique way at Las Vegas and at the fall races at Darlington and Rockingham. The Burton brothers, led by younger sibling Jeff, finished 1-2. By season's end, Ward, crew chief Tommy Baldwin, and car owner Bill Davis earned the admiration of everyone in the series as their team was the only single car effort to finish among the top 10 in points. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the driver of the Caterpillar Pontiac, ninth place in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series point standings, Ward Burton.
Ward, I got to see you shoot some sporting clays a little earlier this year in a fan pairing event in Talladega for that No Bull 5 race, and you hit 24 out of 25 clays. You took aim against the top 10 finish this year, and you hit the mark there too. I want to offer my congratulations from Winston on finishing ninth in the standings, and here's your check in the amount of $244,988.
Well, thanks a lot, Rick. I know I speak for all the drivers and the team when I thank Winston for the support they give us each and every season. I'm proud to be here representing the Caterpillar number 22 team tonight. All season, I felt like the Bill Davis Pontiac has had the potential to be in the top 10 this year, even though we were a single car team. It's great to see the results of the team's hard work. At the end of every season, there are always a lot of people to thank, and that's even true at the end of a season like we've had. The first people I need to thank are Bill and Gail Davis. Since 1995, we've gone through so much together as far as Winston Cup racing. And the loyalty that we have shown each other is paying off tonight. And Tommy Baldwin, I can't thank you enough. You're not only my crew chief, but you're my friend. You brought such organization and enthusiasm to our team. We appreciate the support you and the members of the chassis and the fab shop bring to us. I'd also like to thank my pit crew. I'd put you guys up against anybody any day. And to Terry Ellis, the motor room crew, you really gave the Cat car amazing horsepower and reliability. We couldn't be here tonight if it weren't for you and everyone at the engine department. And to Mike Brown, our team manager, you are our backbone. We work together better because of your leadership. I couldn't talk about everyone who supports the Cat car without thanking all of their families too and their members. Their support makes it possible to do what we do. And now a few words about our sponsors. Some of the most successful names in business, including Caterpillar, Siemens, Amoco, MB&A, Pontiac, Goodyear, and Mountain Dew. I'd like to single out a few of the major sponsors. Thanks to Greg Tolles and the great people at Caterpillar. Your support has been amazing. You and your dealers and customers have taken the time to build our partnership both on and off track. We started our relationship in 1995 when I drove your Busch car, and I knew then that it was a special relationship. Tonight, I feel lucky to represent you and to be a part of the Caterpillar team. A special mention to the folks at MB&A. I really appreciate them not only being really close friends, but supportive of the 22 team and my wildlife foundation. Last sponsor I need to thank is Siemens. Siemens has given us awful lot of support for the 22 car and the 02 Busch Grand National team. A very special thanks to our racing family, Bill France, NASCAR, and R.J. Reynolds. I'm honored to be involved with your great sport. Most of all, I want to thank the great NASCAR fans. Your loyalty means a lot to all of us. As the year went on, it was so awesome to see more and more people wearing the Cat colors. It's your enthusiasm that made NASCAR what it is today. And it's your loyalty that allows me to do what I love to do. Mom, Dad, Brian, without you, Jeff and I wouldn't be successful in racing or life. I know we gave you some anxious moments at places like Vegas, Darlington, and Rockingham. I finally want to recognize my family, especially my wife, Tabitha. Our anniversary is coming up, and I've always been able to count on her love and support. And my kids, Sarah and Jeb, both of you are proud of my life. You sacrificed a lot with your daddy being gone. I love you very much. Thanks again. Happy holidays.
When we come back, we'll have a salute to the eighth place finisher in the points, Rusty Wallace.
Eighth place in the NASCAR Winston Cup point standings goes this year to the driver of the number two Miller Lite Ford Taurus, Rusty Wallace.
1999 was a season that saw Rusty Wallace further entrench himself as one of the NASCAR Winston Cup Series' finest drivers. With his hard-fought victory at the Food City 500 at Bristol in April, Rusty continued a streak that has seen him win at least one race in each of the last 14 seasons. That victory, number 49 of his career, left him only one away from tying Ned Jarrett and Junior Johnson for eighth on the all-time win list. One of the best NASCAR Winston Cup road racers of all time, the 1989 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion further enhanced that reputation by capturing the butt pole at Watkins Glen, one of four that he had throughout the season, tying his career high. Due in part to his 16 top 10 finishes, Rusty earned more points on short tracks than anyone else this season. On the Waldorf Astoria stage for the seventh consecutive year and the 13th time in his career, please welcome the driver of the Penske South Racing Miller Lite Ford, eighth place in the NASCAR Winston Cup point standings, Rusty Wallace.
Rusty, I have to tell you, 14 consecutive years with at least one victory and 7 years consecutively now with a top 10 finish. This has got to be a great year for you, like always. Your good friends at Winston want to congratulate you, and I'm presenting you here tonight with a check for $285,421.
Thank you, Rick.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
Appreciate it. Well, thank you very much. Before I get started, though, I'd like to thank Winston for all they do for the sport. They're a great company, and it's awesome. Dale, I congratulate you and your whole team. And Todd, I'm real proud of you, buddy. You did a good job. I remember him when he was nothing. Now he's something. Well, 99 was a great year. We won. We had four poles. We led a lot of laps and finished eighth in the points. Most importantly, one thing that really feels good to me that I've been in a sport for a long time, and now I can honestly say that I've won for 14 straight years in a row, and that feels good. I'm real proud of that, and for my team and everybody. Next year, we plan on winning a lot more races, and I'm really looking forward to driving the 2000 Ford Taurus. The car looks really hot. I'm really excited about it, and can't hardly wait. Looking forward to working with some new team members. We hired some new people on board at Penske Racing, and hopefully it's going to help our effort. Special thanks to my car owner, Roger Penske, a great partner and a great friend, a fellow that's taught me a whole lot, and to Don Miller, who's been with me since the start. I'd also like to thank Walt Zarnicki, Dan Lugenbuehl, and Greg Penske for all their support and leadership with us. Now I'd like to take time to thank all the fans and thank my sponsors. So if you bear with me for just a little bit, I think it's time to thank those guys. They put a lot of money into it, and they really make it happen. The Miller Brewing Company, Mobile Oil Corporation, Ford Motor Company, Mead Paper Company, Lennox Heating and Cooling, PPG, Bosch Spark Plugs, Goodyear Tire Rubber, Mazak Machinery, Penske Truck Leasing, and Oakley Sunglasses. If you look at that 88 team, you'll see they wear a whole lot of Oakley sunglasses. It's a cool thing to do. And Matco Tools. I'd like to thank my entire Penske Racing team, led by John Erickson and Robert Pemberton. You guys do a great job, and I'm real proud of you. I'd like to thank the Penske Engine Company. I used to have a problem in the past where it seems like it blew a lot of motors, but I can only say one thing right now. I've had one engine failure this year, and it really was an engine failure, so good job, guys. I'm real proud of you. I'd also like to thank Jeremy Mayfield and Michael Kranefis and the entire Penske Kranefis Racing team. They'd helped me a whole lot this year, and we plan on working a lot closer next year and getting back where we were in 98 and get those two cars back up front where they deserve to be. I'd like to thank Action Performance Companies, a number one company in my heart. Those guys are awesome. They make all the cool souvenirs and collectibles for all my fans, a really great company. I'd like to recognize my staff at Rusty Wallace Incorporated, Dick Pacer, Tom Knox, Bill Brooks, Stella Pacer, Roland Carroll, Joyce Kearns, Kim Franklin, Karen Smith, Alan Barbie, and Ron Garrell. I'd also like to recognize the Penske Racing Marketing and PR team. Tom Roberts, who's been with me for 10 years now, that's a long time. Wally McCarty and Cindy Basinger. I'd also like to thank NASCAR's Bill France, Mike Helton, Brian France, George Pine, Gary Nelson, and their entire staff for everything they've done for my team and the entire sport. Well, last but not least, I'd like to thank my family for being so supportive to me over the whole years. And I tell you what, that's a heck of a job. You guys all know that. Well, everybody, thanks a lot, and we'll see you in 2000.
When we come back, Benny and I will tell you about some special awards handed out earlier this evening. We welcome you back to the Grand Ballroom of the Waldorf Astoria in New York City. Now, we'll continue honoring the top 10 in points in just a moment, but Benny first. Earlier today, there were some very special awards given out, including the 1999 Ray Bestis Rookie of the Year Award to a very talented Tony Stewart.
What a rookie. Tony Stewart winning three races in 1999. And folks, you'll get a chance here from Tony Stewart just a little bit later.
And for the second time in 3 years, Ford wins the Manufacturers Championship.
But the first time for the Taurus, Jerry.
And how about one of the surprise awards of the evening, the Marketing Achievement Award, a well-deserved award to the fine folks at Home Depot. And Benny, earlier today, there were some huge checks handed out. Let's take a look.
Exide NASCAR Select Batteries, the official batteries of NASCAR, proudly sponsors the Exide All Charged Up Award. This honor and $3,000 is presented to the eligible driver at every NASCAR Winston Cup race who advances the most positions from his starting position to finish position during the course of the race. Exide Batteries also awards $50,000 to the driver with the most Exide All Charged Up points for the season. This year's winner's strongest showing came in New Hampshire, where he started 39th but still managed to charge up through the pack to take the checkered flag. For the second year in a row, the winner of the Exide All Charged Up Award is the driver of the Exide Batteries Ford, Jeff Burton. True Value is the proud sponsor of the True Value Hard Charger of the Race Award. Points are awarded at every NASCAR Winston Cup Series race to the drivers that race in the top three positions. At season's end, all points are tallied and verified. The drivers with the top three point totals take home a True Value Hard Chargers Award. This year's third place award goes to Mark Martin. And second place honors go to Dale Jarrett. The True Value Hard Charger Award winner is the driver of the number 24 DuPont Automotive Finishes Chevrolet, Jeff Gordon. STP has long been a maker of fine automotive products and a proud sponsor of NASCAR Winston Cup Racing since the early 70s. The prized STP contingency program reaches throughout 10 different NASCAR divisions. In the NASCAR Winston Cup division, STP awards $61,000 at season's end to the top three drivers using STP products. This year, STP is proud to present $40,000 to the top driver in the STP point fund, Ward Burton. Gatorade, the official sport beverage of NASCAR, is proud to sponsor the Gatorade Front Runner Award. Excitement builds at every race as the drivers battle to lead the halfway lap in each race, hoping to collect the award and $10,000 bonus. This year, Jeff Burton captured $30,000 for leading the Gatorade special point standings at the midway point of the season. The year-end award and $50,000 goes to the driver with the most Gatorade Front Runner points for the entire season. The 1999 Gatorade Front Runner Award goes to the driver of the number 18 Interstate Batteries Pontiac, Bobby Labonte. A talented engine builder is a critical component of a successful NASCAR team. To reward that excellence, the Clevite Engine Builder of the Year distributes $80,000 to the top three engine builders of the NASCAR Winston Cup Series based on points earned at selected events. The recipient of the 1999 Clevite Engine Builder of the Year trophy and a $50,000 award is the man behind the motors of the number 88 Quality Care Ford, Doug Yates.
We are just getting started here, so don't go away when we return. Seven-time Winston Cup champion Dale Earnhardt joins us on stage. Back at the Waldorf Astoria, here once again is Rick Sanders.
Seventh place this year was captured by the number three GM Goodrich Service Plus Chevrolet Monte Carlo, Dale Earnhardt.
It's hard to believe it's been 20 years since Dale Earnhardt began competing full-time in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series. Tied with Richard Petty as the only seven-time champions of the sport, Dale was king of the intimidating Talladega High Banks this year. He won both races in exciting fashion, starting 17th and 27th respectively, and is now eligible for the next Winston No Bull 5 bonus at the 2000 Daytona 500. Talladega was indicative of Dale's season. Only three top 10 starts, but 21 top 10 finishes. Not only could he get the job done on the super speedways, but on the short tracks as well, winning the Goody's Headache Powder 500 at Bristol. This is the seventh consecutive season that Dale has finished in the NASCAR Winston Cup Top 10, a feat he has accomplished an amazing 19 times in his career, the most of any driver in the modern era of the series. Completing his 16th consecutive season with car owner Richard Childress, please welcome the driver of the GM Goodrich Service Plus Chevrolet, seventh place in the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup point standings, Dale Earnhardt.
Dale, the NASCAR Winston Cup Series Points Fund probably rewards consistency more than anything else, and I don't think there has been anybody more consistent than you over the years. A seven-time champion, as you heard in the video, in the last 21 years, he has been on this stage with top tens 19 times. That is truly consistency. Here's a check for you for that seventh place finish this year in the amount of $336,146. Congratulations.
Thank you, Rick. Pretty good year. Win a couple races. Jarrett, you guys are a chance, man. You're looking good over there. Robert Yates, congratulations. Told you a long time ago you need to win a championship, man. Finally did it. Proud of you. You know, our race team worked really hard this year and made a big turnaround. It was a tough year for us starting out. Seemed like nothing was going right, but in about May, things turned around for us, started winning a few races, and the team came together. Feel better and better about them. Richard and all the guys worked awful hard. Kevin Hamill, all the team, Spenny Clendon, and everybody in the engine shop. I can't say enough about what Richard has done to try to turn this thing around and make it a championship team again. We've been not been on this stage up here enough in the last several years, and we definitely want to get back there. I think the hard work and the new Monte Carlo is going to help us get back there. And, you know, I can't say enough about what Richard and the guys have done this year and turn it around. And I think the year 2000 is going to be a better year. Win a few races. I know Bristol Terry's still not happy about. But we are talking. He did invite me to go to deer hunting in Texas. I'm not sure I'm going yet. But, I'll let you know, though. Okay. And I did find out when he's going to be in Texas because I hunt down there not far from him, and I didn't want to be there at the same time. I don't even think, but got a lot of sponsors to thank. Of course, GM Goodrich Service Parts has done a great job with us over the years, and we're talking right now of extending our contract with Richard and hopefully keep me in there as a driver for several more years. Everybody talks about retirement. I don't know why. I think it's because a kid, Dale Jr., started racing and they think I should quit. But anyway, we're going to hang in there for a while. But Chevrolet, Snap-on Tools, Burger King, Goodyear Tires, and Coca-Cola Company has done a great job for us this year. Johnny Morris and Bass Pro Shops was a lot of fun this year with got a few extra fishing rods and stuff along the way. Purdue Farms, AC Delco, and Bill Jordan at Realtree Outdoors. I've got to go on a few more hunting trips because of those guys sponsoring us. 76 Racing Gasoline, Featherlight Trailers. Conrad, you did a great job this year with the trailers and everything. Safety Clean, Gargoyle Sunglasses, Chase, Action Performance and Sports Image. Of course, did a great job with all the souvenir apparel this year. I think we've done pretty good in that area anyway. sold a few hats and T-shirts. I know Terry and I sold a lot more after Bristol. Remington Arms, Justin Boots, Anheuser-Busch, NASCAR Cafe, EA Sports, and Silicon Motor Speedway. Just a few folks that on my side, personal endorsements are really good for us this year. I want to thank the France family, Bill and Jimmy, and all the family that worked so hard to help promote and market our sport. And you folks know how well it's came out. They've done a tremendous job, and just like they were talking this week, there used to be 12 of them, and there's 112 of them. So there's a lot of people working on the marketing and licensing side now, but they've done a great job. All the race fans, all I can say is thanks for the support, and just be patient. I'll get your autographs back to you, maybe, but not by Christmas, but soon. I promise you. So it's backed up down at DEI. And all the folks at Dellern Incorporated that done a great job for us there while I was off racing and making a living and paying the bills that you guys were spending, but you still did a great job with Don Hawk and all the folks on board. Teresa and my family. Teresa, she's keeps getting prettier, I think, and it's been a fun time with her. A lot more fun now, too, you know. Got a little more money to spend and go places with her. But it's a lot of fun, and anyway, we've had a great year, I think. Want to say hi to Mark Martin. He's back in Florida there, mending up, and also hi to Susan Bonnet. And it's been a great year for us, and we look forward to it. Y'all have a happy Christmas, and we'll see you next year. God bless.
When we come back, a three-time champion returns to the stage. Jeff Gordon is next. Back at the Waldorf Astoria, our tribute to the top 10 in points continues.
And now on to this year's sixth place finisher. Driver of the number 24 DuPont Automotive Finishes Chevrolet Monte Carlo, Jeff Gordon.
In his seventh NASCAR Winston Cup season, Jeff Gordon earned seven Bud poles to go along with seven victories, the most poles and wins recorded by any driver this year. It all began at the Daytona 500 with a bold late race move that propelled him into victory lane for the second time in his career. He also received an additional $1 million as winner of the Winston No Bull 5 bonus. Plus, a lucky fan paired with Jeff also went home $1 million richer. His winning ways continued at Atlanta, and then in his home state of California, first at Fontana, and then on the Sears Point Road Course. The youngest driver to ever win a championship in the modern era of NASCAR Winston Cup racing, Gordon's next victory came at Watkins Glen, and with it, another all-time record. This one is the winner of most consecutive road course races, five, dating back to 1997. Two late back-to-back wins at Martinsville and Charlotte enabled Jeff to lead the series in wins for the fifth consecutive year. That's another Winston Cup record for the winningest driver of the 90s. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the driver of the Hendrick Motorsports DuPont Automotive Finishes Chevrolet. Sixth place in the 1999 point standings, three-time NASCAR Winston Cup champion, Jeff Gordon.
Jeff, one of the things that's most impressed me throughout this past year is it seems like no matter what happens, you really maintain a positive attitude. But I have to tell you, when I looked at that video, with seven wins and seven poles and a sixth place finish, you got a lot to be positive about. Listen, congratulations. Here's your check for your sixth place finish in the amount of $396,872. But that's not all we also have contained in here. That $1 million you won in the No Bull 5 event back in Daytona earlier this year. Congratulations.
Oh, that's great. Thank you very much, Rick. I tell you what, it's great to be here. And you know, you look at your season and you try to figure out, you know, just what makes up a great season. We're all very competitive. And so then you look at where you're at in the points and how many DNFs you had and what you could have done to make your season better. But then you say to yourself, wait a minute, I won the Daytona 500, won the most poles and the most races. And then you say to yourself, what really makes
a great season. And I realized that just being a part of this sport is what makes a great year. So with that, I'd like to thank the people that make this sport what it is. I'd like to thank NASCAR and RJ Reynolds for allowing all of us to do what we do and what we love to do week after week. I'd like to congratulate Dale Jarrett. You know, fantastic job this year. I really admire you for the way you handle yourself on and off the racetrack, and that, you know, that means a lot to me and a lot of other people out there. But I really believe that you're a true champion long before you're ever NASCAR Winston Cup champion, and I know we all appreciate that very much. You know, we weren't without our changes and challenges this year, though. And by pulling together and working together as a team, we accomplished some great things. The first person I'd like to recognize is Ray Evernham. Ray, you've been an important part of my life, and as a crew chief, a partner, and a friend, you've always been there. You've helped to make the 24 team what it is today, and I wish you nothing but the best as you pursue your dreams. Next, I'd like to thank Brian Weitzel. Brian did a great job, had some pretty big shoes to fill there, bud. And you filled them right up by jumping in and winning the first two races as our leader and at Martinsville and Charlotte, and that was pretty incredible. You know, these guys went through a lot this year, and I gotta thank them for everything that they've done to stay with us this year through all these changes. I appreciate your support, guys. You give our team so much depth, and I know that we'll continue to be a strong force in the future. To Rick Hendrick, what can I say? Our thoughts and prayers have been with you as you've battled through leukemia, and we know you're getting better, and we can't wait for you to join us and get it started to a healthy start in year 2000. And John, we appreciate everything that you do. You've got a tough job. You've done a great job while Rick was sick, and we really thank you for all you've done and for putting up with us too. There's so many people to thank. My wife, Brooke, how can I thank you enough? You're such an incredible support. You support me so much, and I appreciate everything that you do. I love you so much, appreciate that. And also, like to thank my family. It's great to have such a supportive and built-in fan club with me each and every day and on and off the racetrack. And all the behind-the-scenes guys at Hendrick Motorsports, the R&D group, the chassis group, everyone in the engine shop. I definitely wouldn't be here if it weren't for you guys and for your hard work and your dedication. I certainly want to thank the sponsors that keep us running, keep us on the track and being competitive. Thanks to DuPont Automotive Finishes, DuPont Corporate Businesses, and to Chevy for all those great cars, and I'm really looking forward to the 2000 Monte Carlo. We appreciate the support we get from Quaker State, GMAC, Advanced Auto Parts, Pepsi, Kellogg's, Goodyear, and all the other names and logos that cover the number 24 all season long. And Action Performance and Hasbro Toys for providing all those great fans with great products and services. And speaking of great fans, there's one more team member that I must thank, and I do think that they're a part of our team each and every time we're out there on the track, and that's our great fans. It means so much to me and our team to have such a loyal group of people cheering us on, win or lose, and we thank you for that. You know, this year we've seen this sport really continue to grow, and we know that it's gonna just continue to take off in years to come. There are a lot of new names, new faces, new racetracks, and this has been the most competitive season that I've ever seen. And I think it's only going to get stronger. And I'm very proud to be a part of NASCAR Winston Cup Racing, and I can't wait to get it started again next year. You know, God has answered so many of my prayers, and I hope that He answers each and every one of yours. And I want to thank you and wish you all the best. God bless. Thank you.
Jeff Gordon, a major player in NASCAR's exciting future, Benny and I will explain when we return.
The driver of the number 99 X-Side Ford Taurus finished fifth in this year's standings, Jeff Burton.
Jeff Burton, the younger of the two racing Burton brothers, staked his early season claim as a championship contender with a victory at Las Vegas, following an exciting duel with his brother that would be repeated several times throughout the season.
It looks like he's coming down. Doesn't it feel good?
Just 2 weeks later, a dramatic Darlington win in the Trans-South Financial 400 would propel him into the NASCAR Winston Cup points lead, a position he would hold for the next 2 months. Many of his runs were not without drama. With only 10 top 10 starts, Jeff consistently made his way from the back of the pack to the front with 23 top 10 finishes that included 18 in the top five. Jeff was bullish when the Winston No Bull 5 bonus money was on the line. He dominated NASCAR Winston Cup Racing's longest race with a win at the Lowe's Motor Speedway in the Coca-Cola 600, touching off a celebration that brightly lit the Memorial Day weekend sky. A Darlington sweep was accomplished with a Pepsi Southern 500 victory that earned Burton another No Bull $1 million bonus in a race that is still close to the heart of this Virginia native. And for the second time, a fan paired with Jeff became an instant millionaire. Wins at Loudoun and Rockingham ran his victory total to 6, the most productive season in his still blossoming career. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the driver of the Roush Racing Exide Batteries Ford, 5th in the NASCAR Winston Cup standings for the second consecutive season, Jeff Burton.
Jeff, 6 wins in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series and a 5th place finish. I'd say all around it's been a pretty good year. Of course, that's on the track. Off the track, you're still going to have to deal with the fact that your brother is a little better shot at sporting plays than you are. But I've got here your check for your 5th place finish in the amount of $502,597,000. And we have included beyond that a little extra something. That's that $2 million that you won in those No Bull 5 finishes in Darlington and Charlotte. Congratulations.
Thank you. Well, I want to thank you for these very generous checks. It's amazing the amount of money that Winston's given to this sport. And Kim, I guess we better add those guys to our Christmas card list this year. Seems appropriate. Before I go any further, I want to say hi to Mark Barton at home. He is Roush Racing, and he's doing really well, and we miss him being here. He is what Roush Racing is all about. As the final season of the century ends, I can honestly say how proud I am to be part of what I believe has become the greatest sport in the country. I believe we've proven the worth of NASCAR and the fact that we are the sport of the new millennium. It truly is an exciting time to be in Winston Cup racing. First and foremost, though, NASCAR is about the fans. We have, without any question, the most loyal fans in any sport, period. Our fans are the most committed. Go down the road, you'll see a number 6 bumper sticker. You'll see Jeff Gordon t-shirts in any store. And every now and then, you might see some with Jeff Burton on it, but you gotta look kinda hard. It's obvious that corporate America has learned that if they support racing, the fans will support them. We must never underestimate the commitment of our fans because they are Winston Cup racing. NASCAR is also about the dedication of its teams. I can honestly say that the XI team never lost its desire to perform at the highest level every single week. Jack Roush gives us everything we need to win. Buddy Perry provides us with the great leadership that it takes to win. And as I told you this time last year, Frank Stoddard does what it takes to get our car in victory lane. All of our crew lives and breathes their job. They love it. They love what they do. And you can tell. They've given me the best equipment I've ever sat in my life. This is truly a team effort. I'm really lucky to be surrounded by a group this good. I'm also lucky because our sponsors have been so loyal. Exide has been with us for 5 years, Ford also. Mayflower and Bosch have been with us for 4 years, Parts Plus for 3. We've also had the support of SKF and Chicago Rawhide, BorgWarner and Coca-Cola. And Nanticoke Homes just joined us this year. That kind of corporate belief goes a long way toward putting together a successful team. There's no way our team could be successful, and their commitment is essential to our success. We hear a lot about family in NASCAR racing. I'm very fortunate to have Kim and Paige with me every single week. That means a lot to me. My family's given up a lot so I can do what I want to do. All of the families in racing and the friends of racing have made huge sacrifices so the loved ones can do what they love to do, and that's living out their dream. This is a very exciting year for us.
but it was also a little disappointment. We didn't reach our goal of winning the championship. Those guys over there, they showed us how to get that done. Great job. You guys deserved it. Six wins is a great year, and I'm proud of winning six races. We led the points for the first time. We even helped two fans become the millionaire. And the best part about it was we didn't have to hear Regis Philbin say, "Is that your final answer?" I know that made me happy. This year, more than ever, though, I believe we learned what it takes to contend for a championship. We hope we can apply these lessons into next year. We never make promises about our performance, but the one thing that we will promise is that we will work as hard as we know how to, with a lot of desire. We truly have a group of winners. Hopefully we can go and see how good we can do next year. It'll be a heck of a challenge. Thank you, guys.
Fourth place in the NASCAR Winston Cup point standings was captured this year by our rookie, the driver of the number 20 Home Depot Pontiac Grand Prix, Tony Stewart.
Tony Stewart's goal entering his first season of NASCAR Winston Cup racing was to run as many laps as possible, learn the tracks, and just stay out of trouble. But anyone who knows Tony knew it would only be a matter of time before he would become a tiger on the racetrack. Early on, Tony and his Greg Zipidelli-led crew were getting it right in qualifying. A front row start at Daytona, the butt pole at Martinsville. After a strong fourth-place finish in the season's longest contest, the Coca-Cola 600 at Charlotte, Stewart continued to hone his cockpit skills. He built upon statistics that would include, by season's end, the highest-finishing rookie in 32 of the 34 races. He would complete 98% of all laps run, a strong statement by this newly formed venture.
And in his 25th NASCAR Winston Cup race, Tony Stewart wins at Richmond International Raceway.
Finally, after a couple of near misses, the breakthrough first victory occurred at Richmond, an event he dominated. Phoenix, a similar story, and victory number two. Stewart became the first rookie since the late Davey Allison to win two races in a season. Homestead, Miami was next on the schedule, and Tony had a date with the record books. Using a daring late race move to get past teammate Bobby Labonte, Tony became the winningest rookie in NASCAR Winston Cup history. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the driver of the Joe Gibbs Racing Home Depot Pontiac. Fourth place in the final NASCAR Winston Cup point standings, the 1999 Rookie of the Year, Tony Stewart.
Tony and I were talking over dinner, and I know that one of your primary goals this year was to get that yellow stripe off your bumper. Well, I don't think you have to take it off. I think you tore it off yourself with three wins and a great finish in the Winston Cup standings. So here's your check from Winston and NASCAR in the amount of $548,322. Congratulations.
Well, if I can keep Joe from trying to beat me out of this on the golf course, this will go a long way at home. So I can spend this at Home Depot this week. It's just been a great rookie season for us, and you know, we obviously wanted to do well for everyone at Home Depot, and obviously everyone at Joe Gibbs Racing who believed in us and took a chance on a rookie this year. It really has meant a lot to us. We gained a lot of experience this year, and we learned a lot from all the veteran drivers, and I want to thank all the veterans for all that support this year and all that knowledge that they gave away freely. It really went a long way, and we appreciate their support. We also wanted to congratulate Dale and Robert on a great season. You guys definitely set an example on what it takes to win championships in the future, so thank you for your leadership also. Also want to especially thank Bobby Labonte, Jimmy Maycar, the entire Interstate Batteries team, and just everybody at Joe Gibbs Racing. You know, congratulations on your second place finish in the points this year. Also want to thank Joe, even though he tries to beat me out on my paychecks every week on the golf course, it means a lot to have a car owner that took the time to let me learn in the rookie, not only in the rookie season this year, but in the Busch Gardens National Series before I felt like I was ready to come to Winston Cup, and that means a lot. A lot of car owners get in a hurry, and it meant a lot to have your support this year, Joe. Also want to thank Mark Cronquist, our head engine builder, and all of his staff, everybody at the fab shop, and all the ladies upstairs that make the day-to-day operations at Joe Gibbs Racing just run a little smoother each week. I also want to thank, last but not least, Greg Zipidelli, who really had to test himself this year. I think as a rookie crew chief, he had a lot of pressures on his shoulders, and dealing with a rookie driver this year had to double that load. But Greg took it all in stride and really made me comfortable in the race car this year, and that really meant a lot to us. Also want to thank the people at Home Depot, Arthur Blank, Bernie Marcus, Bruce Burke, who really got the ball rolling, Dick Sullivan, Hugh and Christine, and all the rest of the motorsports staff for all you've done for us this year, and especially with the Home Depot effort that I ran, or the double duty effort I ran in May. It meant a lot to have your support for both of those races. And I couldn't go on without thanking the 190,000 associates that work in 900 stores at Home Depot across the country. Knowing that you're behind us every Sunday watching on TV really means a lot to us. I also want to thank Rigid, Husky, Coca-Cola, Nike, MB&A, Gumout, Daewoo, and Action Performance for all you do on the side for us. It really means a lot. And a special thanks to Goodyear and Pontiac. I think you two are the unsung heroes that don't get enough recognition in this sport. We appreciate all your hard work and all you do for us. I also want to take a minute to think about a great friend of mine, Glenn Nibel, who was my car owner in 95 in the Silver Crown and Sprint Car Series, who's battling with cancer. Our thoughts and prayers with you and your family this week. I also want to thank Harry Rainier, who we lost this year. Harry was the one that gave me my first start in Busch National Series in 86, and it was a great loss losing him this year, and we lost a great friend. I also want to thank everyone at RJ Reynolds for all your support with the Winston Cup Series, and all the NASCAR officials for definitely making this a very fun rookie season. It meant a lot to have all your support this year, and you guys make it fun for all of us on the weekends. And last but not least, all the NASCAR fans who every week, you guys are there religiously, whether it's raining in the stands or not. You're there supporting us and all we do. And without you guys, we couldn't make it happen. Thank you. We'll see you next year.
Just the first of what I believe will be many visits to this stage over the years for phenomenal rookie driver Tony Stewart. We'll be back. Back at the Waldorf Astoria, once again from Sports Marketing Enterprises, here is Rick Sanders.
Capturing third place in the standings, driver of the number 6 Valvoline Cummins Ford Taurus, Mark Martin.
Athlete, race car driver, Mark Martin. He first came to the big leagues as a 22-year-old, getting his first start at North Wilkesboro. But his big break occurred 7 years later when he teamed up with car owner Jack Roush to run the NASCAR Winston Cup Circuit full-time. Since then, they've finished in the top 10 in NASCAR Winston Cup points for 11 consecutive seasons, the longest current streak in the series. Everyone knows how difficult it is just to qualify for a NASCAR Winston Cup race. Mark started in the top 10 26 times, more than anyone else. He won the spring race at Rockingham and captured the butt pole for the fall race there. But in between was forced to play hurt. With typical Mark Martin bravado, he overcame the adversity, consistently finishing near the front before finally winning the grueling MBNA Gold 400 at Dover. The winningest driver in the history of the NASCAR Busch Grand National Series, Mark completed the 1999 Winston Cup season with 26 top 10s and 19 top 5s. The driver of the Roush Racing Valvoline Cummins Ford, the third place finisher in the NASCAR Winston Cup standings, Mark Martin.
Now, as most of you probably know, Mark had back surgery the Monday following the last race of the season in Atlanta, and he was hoping to recover in time to get here tonight. And unfortunately, the doctors thought it was just a little bit too early for him to be traveling. So he's not here with us tonight. But Mark, I know you're watching at home, and I want to let you know that all of us here wish you were here with us as well. We'll keep you in our prayers, and hopefully you'll have a speedy and full recovery. I also want to let you know, Mark, that your performance in 1999 was nothing short of remarkable, especially in light of the pain and the injuries that you suffered during the season. With 26 top 10 starts, 26 top 10 finishes, and 19 top fives, you really redefined the words commitment and tenacity. Congratulations to you. Now, we are lucky enough to have Mark's response to these words about his third place finish and his check for $9,000 to Mark Martin.
This year I broke 4 bones. 3 broke racing. The 4th one broke from just general wear and tear. The first 3 have healed, I'm working right now on getting my back healed up. I've had so many letters of support from fans this year, I can't even begin to count them all. But I want to thank you for every one of them. In spite of all the wreckage to my body this year, the only thing I can think of to tell you tonight is how lucky I am and have been. Even when things look bad. When I was 5, my dad stood me up in the driver's seat, pushed his foot down on the gas, and gave me the steering wheel. I was lucky I survived. I'm also lucky my son Matt won his first championship without ever having to stand on my lap and drive. In 1983, things looked real bad. I had to quit Winston Cup racing, auction off all my racing equipment, and start over again. I was lucky I failed. If I hadn't failed that year, I wouldn't have gone home to Arkansas and met Arlene. That was luck. And I was even luckier the day I talked her into marrying me. And if I hadn't failed in 1983, I wouldn't have met Jimmy Finney in the ASA series. And let me tell you, that was luck. And without having to start over again, I would have never met Jack Roush. So sometimes when you think life is just plain miserable, your luck may be just around the corner. I've also had some luck without first having to take a dose of misery. I've got a team of guys that are behind me 100%, and they give 100% all the time. And you can ask any Winston Cup driver in racing how hard it is to get 100% of the guys behind you 100% of the time. Jimmy Finney, Sean Parker, and the entire Valvoline crew simply amazed me this year. You guys are the best. And having some of America's best companies to support your career doesn't hurt either. Valvoline, Eagle One, Cummins Engines, and Bugles have all teamed up for several years now in Winston Cup to fuel our competitive engine, while the Winn-Dixie stores have helped me win all those Busch races. And I continue to race and receive support from Ford Motor Company and Goodyear. For all the luck I've had, there is one piece of luck that has escaped me. With the loss of my dad last year, I've lost the opportunity to someday share with him the experience of winning the Winston Cup Championship. So I know how absolutely wonderful the Jarrett family must feel tonight to be able to celebrate together. Ned, Martha, Dale, Glenn, Patty, you are the role models for the rest of us in this sport. You know, it simply amazes me that a father and a son can know the joy of winning the greatest championship in motorsports. It's even more amazing that this isn't the first time that a father and son have won the championship. And I'm hoping that someday there'll be another father and son celebration. And I'm hoping that celebration will take place right here in the Waldorf Astoria. And I'm hoping that that night it will be my son Matt and I celebrating our championship together.
Those emotional words from a little man with a huge heart. Hurry back, Mark, we miss you. And oh, by the way, nice jet. Back in a moment. Back at the Grand Ballroom with the Waldorf Astoria, now the Winston Cup points runner-up.
And now for our runner-up, finishing second in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series this year, in our point standings, driver of the number 18 Interstate Batteries Pontiac Grand Prix, Bobby Labonte.
1999 was a phenomenal year for Bobby Labonte in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series as he set new career personal bests for butt poles, race victories, and final points position. Consistently running at the front of the pack, Labonte would lead more races than any other driver in this magic season for his Pontiac team, led by owner Joe Gibbs and crew chief Jimmy Maycock. No one would be better on the Super Speedways in 1999, Bobby's first win of the season came at the MBNA Platinum 400 in Dover from his Bud pole starting position. At Pocono, Labonte would sweep to victory in both events, as well as winning the Pepsi 400 at Michigan in August. Accumulating a season total of 26 top 10 finishes, Bobby would never be out of the top five in points following the second race of the season at Rockingham. The exclamation point to Labonte's incredibly satisfying season would come with win number five at the Napa 500 at Atlanta with another dominating performance. Completing his fifth full season for Joe Gibbs Racing, please welcome this year's runner-up for the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship, the driver of the Interstate Batteries Pontiac, Bobby Labonte.
Well, Bobby, it seemed it was never real hard to find you throughout most of this year. All you had to do was look towards the front of the pack, and you were either there or kind of on everybody's heels. Take a look at the year. Five wins, five poles, 23 top five finishes. And we even gave you a couple more shots at that Winston No Bowl Five, $1 million fund. Congratulations to you on a second place finish. We've got a check for you from Winston and NASCAR in the amount of $1,039,773.
That's a lot of money, a lot of money. I'll have to say, for you people keeping score at home, it's 0-7 on the Winston thing, Winston No Bowl Five, so maybe I'll get it one of these days, but Rick, I really appreciate it. Hopefully I'm gonna try to get through this speech without using one of my lifelines. I might have to ask for 50-50 from the audience, so you never know. RJ Reynolds and the Winston brand have really supported NASCAR racing, and I just wanna thank them for that. And I'm also grateful to the France family, Mike Helton, and everyone at NASCAR for having the greatest racing series in the world. Thank you guys. Remember last year when I was up here, I was so excited to finish six in points, which I was. Well, I had no idea that this year I would be this close to seeing and congratulating Dale Jarrett on winning his first championship, and probably not his last. Dale, Robert, Doug, Todd, all the guys up there, you had a great year. Congratulations, guys. When I look at all what Joe Gibbs Racing has accomplished this year, it shows me what type of organization it is. The year started off strong, winning a twin 125 at Daytona, and then winning five more races with the 18 car, and Tony winning three races. That's just an incredible season, and I tell you what, we had a lot of fun, too. It was great. I want to thank all the people at Joe Gibbs Racing. They are great people. I wish you could be here with us right now. Joe and Jimmy knew we had the ability, and everyone came together and showed the strength of championship teams. It takes a lot of people to be successful in NASCAR Winston Cup racing, and I have to recognize a few of them. First of all, my wife, Donna, beautiful lady she is. I couldn't have gotten here without your support and love. My kids, Tyler and Madison, without them, I couldn't enjoy all those Hasbro games that we play together. You're such a great family. And to Jimmy Makar and the entire Interstate Batteries team, who put their heart and soul into making this year our best season yet. I wish all of you could be up here with me. And I certainly want to thank all my sponsors, Norm, Tommy Miller, and everyone at Interstate Batteries. Your charged up attitude makes this team a great success. And I look forward to continuing that for many years to come. Charged up, remember that. You guys have it. And in order not to leave out any of my other sponsors, I brought along my favorite action performance die-cast car. We have a lot of sponsors I gotta thank. MBNA, Pontiac, Goodyear, Planners, Champion, Circuit City, Cintas, Coca-Cola, Ditch Witch, Easy Care, Husqvarna, Daewoo, Sickens, Food Lion, and Wix Filters, and all the people on the front. Now, you get the idea by now, I guess. It's a great car. And finally, to all those loyal fans who support all the drivers and teams week in and week out. Y'all are the greatest fans in sports, and thank you for a great 1999 season. See ya. You're next.
When we come- come back, the championship awards a portion of our program, so stay tuned. The 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards Banquet continues. Now back to the stage and Mike Tirico.
Now the front table will join the festivities. Are you ready, guys? Let's start with the award for the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship Series Crew Chief. Here to present that, NASCAR Winston Cup Series Director, Mr. Gary Nelson.
Thank you, Mike. I'm honored to be here tonight to present this esteemed award to the vital member of the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Championship Team. Todd Parrott has revolutionized the role of NASCAR Winston Cup Series Crew Chief with his leadership and his intense focus on teamwork. On behalf of NASCAR and race fans everywhere, congratulations, Todd.
Thank you, Gary. Good evening, everyone. I want to start by thanking the people who have made it all possible for us to be here tonight. Bill, Betty Jane France, Mike, Linda Helton, Gary, Christine Nelson, and all of the NASCAR officials. You're the backbone of the greatest form of auto racing in the world. I'm proud to be a part of it. And to RJ Reynolds, thanks for all your support. You're the reason we're the NASCAR Winston Cup champions. Over the past 10 years, I've sat almost everywhere in this room. There have even been a few years that I wasn't here at all. So if you're here tonight, consider yourself lucky. And if you're watching from home, consider yourself lucky too. You're probably a lot more comfortable than I am. 10 years ago, I sat in the balcony where our championship team is tonight. I can tell you from experience, those guys have worked their tails off to get here. There are no weak links in a championship team, and they're all champions. They have dedicated themselves to make us run better and faster than the rest of the competition week after week. Their never give up attitude is why I have the honor to be on this stage tonight. I also know from experience those guys are having the time of their lives up there, and they deserve it. How about a round of applause for them guys? There were a few years when I worked on a team that maybe have won a championship, should have won a championship, but we didn't. We won more races than anyone. We came up a little bit short in the end. But I appreciate the time that I spent with Rusty Wallace, Roger Penske, and what I learned working under such great crew chiefs as Barry Dodson, Jimmy Maycar, Eddie Dickerson, Robert Pemberton, and my dad, Buddy Parrott. Then Robert Yates took me in with Larry McReynolds as a team manager, and that first year, like a dream, Cinderella story, some people said. When I came to the banquet in 1996, sat way back there in the back where Kenny Wallace is sitting tonight. We finished third in the points that year, and when Dale talked about what I had done for his racing career, I got pretty emotional. I was just amazed that I was actually here and associated with such an incredible group of people. The past 2 years, I've been fortunate enough to sit up front. Dale said he wanted to make sure I was up here so I could get a real good look at this head table. Catfish, we did it. We're family sitting up here where everyone in this room would like to sit. But you know what? It's not so much the table or where it is, but the people who are here sitting with me tonight. Edsel Ford is a great guy. Not only is his family a legend in automotive history, but he's an excellent host. Just go to his room around 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. Ask Jeff Gordon. Doug Yates is probably the hardest working guy in racing and one who hardly takes any of the credit. Doug is the person behind the famous Robert Yates horsepower. He puts his heart and soul and then some into that engine shop. Robert, Carol, and Yates are more like family to me. Robert is the most caring and honest person I know. He took a big chance when he hired me, and I'll always remember that. I'm so proud to be a part of his first NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. How much time have I got left? Dale Jarrett, what else can I say about this guy? He and Kelly are the finest people I've ever known. Dale and I have a mutual respect and trust that surpasses all understanding. My wife says Dale and I have our own language. We even finish each other's own sentences sometimes, and I'll bet that's scary to some of you. But that's a big part of how we got up here tonight. Dale never fails to give me credit for our accomplishments, and let me tell you, Dale Jarrett, you're a true champion in every sense of the word. The other person on this stage that has a lot to do with me getting here tonight is my wife, Debbie. She convinced me to take this job when Robert Yates offered it to me 4 years ago. So Robert, Dale, you really owe her a lot. She sacrifices a lot for me to work the hours that I do. Thank you, Debbie. Our boys, Tyler and Chandler, are at home tonight. I love them more than life itself. The other people who mean a lot to me are my parents, Judy and Buddy Parrott, and my brother, Brad. I'm fortunate to work in the same industry as my dad and my brother, but it can get a little tense when our cars are running first and second, as you all know. Us parents are competitive people. We can be the fiercest competitors, but I still never forget he's my dad. On that note, if you are able to spend time during this holiday season with your family and friends, count yourself fortunate. Remember God's blessings because he has blessed us all. And surround yourself with meaningful people just like I have done tonight on this stage. Good night and God bless you.
Todd Parrott, an example that hard work and a never-say-die attitude indeed pays off. We'll be back.
Born in Charlotte, North Carolina, he began his motorsports career as a drag racer by the age of 16. By 26, he was a mechanic at the famed Holman Moody Shops. In 1969, he built the winning engine of the Daytona 500, won by Leroy Yarborough. In the 70s, he developed engine programs for Junior Johnson, Diegard Racing, helping legends such as Cale Yarborough, Bobby Allison, and Darrell Waltrip win 54 races in that decade. In 1983, he sat here at this stage as the engine builder for the championship team and champion driver Bobby Allison. He left NASCAR briefly in 1985, but it was Harry Reniere's team that lured him back in 1986 to again develop an engine program. After the 1988 season, he seized the opportunity to live his dream to become a NASCAR Winston Cup car owner. He purchased a team from Reniere. At that moment, a new era began to develop. Since his inaugural season in 1989, his teams have won at least one race each season and won 42 races total with 26 poles. Through many trials and tribulations, he pressed on. He pressed on to reach his ultimate dream, and that ultimate dream became real this season. It's all these facts that allow me to say tonight with great confidence that on behalf of all of NASCAR, it's not just a company based in Daytona Beach owned by a France family, but of all of NASCAR, from the quarter mile track drivers and mechanics who share his passion to the peers in the NASCAR Winston Cup garage, I respectfully envy his success. All join me in proudly presenting the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Championship Car Owners Trophy to a true American hero, Robert Yates.
Thank you very much.
It's an honor to be here, and probably wouldn't be here except for a decision I made back in 1986. I was building engines for a lot of teams back then, and two guys, Harry Rainier and Rick Kendrick, both wanted me to come to work for them. I scheduled meetings with both of them one night, and at the last minute, Rick had to back out because his mom was sick. Well, Harry said he only needed 5 minutes, and he was right. In 5 minutes, he convinced me to go to work for him. In 1988, Harry decided to sell the team. Davey Allison was the driver at the time, and it was him who convinced me to take the responsibility and become owner of the team. Texaco and Havoline were our first sponsors. They really stepped out and helped us, believed a lot in us, and got us going. Our first few races were a struggle. Eventually, it got better and better. Larry McReynolds joined us in 1991, and we became contenders practically every week. But then we lost Davey. That was really hard on me, and I wasn't sure I wanted to go on racing. But I had a team that depended on me, so we went on. Ernie Irvin stepped in and did a great job. But when he got hurt in 1994, I needed a driver to fill his seat, maybe for a whole year. One of the resumes that came across my desk was Dale Jarrett's. I was interested in Dale Jarrett because I remembered how he won his first race, beating Davey Allison in a side-by-side race at Michigan. I thought he could race, but more importantly, he told me he could win in my car. He told me that if he couldn't win in the 28 car, maybe he should become a professional golfer. I guess he was at a turning point in his career. My hiring Dale Jarrett turned out to be a blessing in disguise. That's what led to a two-car race team for Robert Yates Racing. When Ford Quality Care came to me in 1995, they were looking for a team that could beat the Goodrich team and Dale Earnhardt. I knew I had my work cut out for me, but I took on the responsibility of filling the second car. It was perfect. Ernie was ready to make his comeback in the 28 car, and I could keep Dale Jarrett. Like a fairy tale, Jarrett and Todd won their first race together at the 1996 Daytona 500. And Earnhardt ran second, and the rest is history. The 88 car has been everything a car owner could wish for. They've never finished worse than third in the points, which is a huge accomplishment for any team. And winning the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship in the fourth season is unbelievable. I'm just honored to be the owner. In a day and a time when the institution of the family is put to the test, I'm honored to be involved in a sport that is so family-oriented. The Francis have created something that we can all be proud of. My championship driver, Dale Jarrett, is the son of a former Winston Cup champion, Ned Jarrett. There is no better family in racing that represents the sponsors and sport in such an outstanding way. Todd Parrott, the son of the famous crew chief, Buddy Parrott. I know Buddy is as proud of Todd tonight as I am. Doug Yates, our head engine builder, happens to be my son. To work with my son has been very special for me. And let me tell you, we would not be up here tonight without Doug's hard work on the engine program. But the reason I'm doubly good, I have a twin brother, Richard Yates, and he's our business manager. Thanks for handling the business so I can go racing. And Ethel Ford, he's a great-grandson of Henry Ford, a champion car builder. Ford is our primary sponsor. I'm proud of that, but I'm even more proud to just say I know Ethel. We had a mechanically perfect season. That's what Ford Quality Care and Ford Credit are all about. My daughter, Amy, isn't involved in racing, and that's okay. She's probably the one with the most sense in our family anyway. You're not mad at Amy, are you? Here's the one with the most sense, Carolyn. My wife, Carolyn, is a true support system and has been there with me since the beginning. I couldn't have made it without her. I love her for hanging in there with me. Thank you all for allowing me to tell the story of how I got here tonight. This is one of the biggest events of my life. And I appreciate everybody who helped me get here. Thank you a lot. And may God bless each one of you as good as he's blessed me. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Todd, Mr. Ford, and Robert, these members of the 99 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Championship Team. DJ, are you ready? You were. Ladies and gentlemen, we know him, but let's meet the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Champion.
For the final time in this millennium, we crown our 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup champion. The generational torch has again been passed. The future is now. The story of Dale Jarrett's quest is one of patience, performance, and perseverance. Qualities we've seen demonstrated throughout his entire career. This smooth veteran, his confident crew chief, and his seasoned owner combined their skills into a potent combination of on-track savvy, bullseye strategy, and a crafted piece of machinery that set all-time records for consistency. Following the Food City 500 at Bristol in April, Jarrett climbed to second in the NASCAR Winston Cup point standings. Three consecutive top 10 finishes preceded the Pontiac Excitement 400 at Richmond, a race Dale led only once. But it was for the final 31 laps. Along with his first victory of the season, DJ took the coveted seat atop the point standings. From that moment on, the Quality Care Ford Credit Ford juggernaut racked up an amazing 11 straight top six finishes, including wins at the Kmart 400 at Michigan, the Pepsi 400 at Daytona, and the Brickyard 400 at Indianapolis. Jarrett held tight to a points lead he would never relinquish. When he crossed the finish line at Homestead Miami Speedway in fifth, a 22-year driving career peaked with the ultimate prize in motorsports. Dale Jarrett and his two-time champion father, Ned, had now joined Lee and Richard Petty in the elite echelon as NASCAR Winston Cup father-son champions. The final entry of the century shows four wins, 24 top five, and 29 top 10 finishes. Four times, Dale Jarrett captured the Winston Cup points leader bonus money. The future is now. Forget Y2K, it's YDJ. Ladies and gentlemen, the driver of the Quality Care Ford Credit Ford, owned by Robert Yates, your 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup champion, Dale Jarrett.
Just around the corner, so stay with us. A different kind of sun is about to shine. We'll be back.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the President and Chief Executive Officer of the R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, Mr. Andy Schindler.
Thank you. I'm very pleased to be here tonight to celebrate this final event of the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup season. This season marked not only the 29th year of partnership between R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company and NASCAR, but also the last season of this century. Next year, the year 2000, will be the first racing season of the new millennium, and R.J. Reynolds' 30th year as the sponsor of the NASCAR Winston Cup Series. All of us at Winston and RJ Reynolds feel proud and privileged to be part of this fantastic NASCAR family. The NASCAR Winston Cup family includes the millions of devoted race fans across the country, the many talented and competitive race teams, dozens of dedicated officials, and hundreds of enthusiastic and committed sponsors. The entire NASCAR family plays a role in making the NASCAR Winston Cup Series such a spectacular success. Heading that NASCAR family is Bill France. Without his vision, commitment, and leadership, NASCAR racing would not be what it is today. Thank you, Bill, for all the great things you do for this great sport. Tonight, the NASCAR Winston Cup spotlight belongs to Dale Jarrett. Dale and the never-give-up spirit of this Robert Yates race team helped bring us a very exciting season of NASCAR Winston Cup racing. They overcame obstacle after obstacle this season, but nothing was going to seize the championship away from this great team, a team that is deeply rooted in NASCAR racing. Robert Yates' life is racing, and he has reached the peak of success through persistence, intense determination, and a never-give-up attitude. Robert is quiet and reserved, but anyone who knows him realizes that under that quiet reserve lies a smart, tough, and very fierce competitor. This year's achievement is proof of those qualities. Like Robert, Crew Chief Todd Parrott is deeply rooted in NASCAR Winston Cup racing. I'm sure Dale would agree that he would not be here tonight without the extraordinary efforts of Todd and the number 88 team. This team has given true meaning to their motto, never give up. Let's have a round of applause for the number 88 Quality Care Ford Credit Ford Taurus team. Let's hear it for them. Dale is here tonight as the champion. This year's winner of the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. Dale grew up with racing in his blood. He was born the same year his father, Ned, began his NASCAR driving career. He grew up racing at Hickory Motor Speedway, and Dale and Ned are only the second father and son to have captured NASCAR championships. Over the years, Dale firmly established his racing talent and intensified his desire to win. This year's NASCAR Winston Cup season takes Dale to the pinnacle of his long racing career. He has earned the highest honor in NASCAR Winston Cup racing. Dale began this season with a slow start in Daytona, but after Daytona, he quickly picked up the pace. He had excellent results in the next 10 races, and by the 11th race in Richmond, Dale had taken the points lead for the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. From that point on, he never gave up that lead. Dale ended the season with 4 victories, 24 top 25, and 29 top 10 finishes. From Dale Jarrett to Robert Yates, to Todd Parrott, and the entire number 88 Ford racing team, you demonstrated to the country the attitude and true winning spirit of a never give up racing team. That attitude and spirit were the roadmap for your success, success that was achieved through commitment, a positive attitude, and lots of hard work. We're very proud to have Dale and his team here tonight to celebrate their great victory. Okay, DJ, now the moment you've been waiting for. Tonight, I have the honor and the pleasure of presenting you with this check for $2,965,767. Congratulations, man.
Carol, do you want this now or later?
Okay. It's definitely going in the pocket. It was the last 2 years I was up here, I left it laying right here. But thanks to all of our very trustworthy competitors, they got it back to me. Before I get started, I want to congratulate two young men that we're going to be seeing a lot of on this stage. Tony Stewart on your Rookie of the Year, Dale Earnhardt Jr. on your second Busch Grand National Championship. I know Mark Martin, you're watching, and I just want to say hello to you, a speedy recovery to the ultimate competitor that we have in this business. The courage you showed this year is just incredible, and we wish you the best, a great holiday season, and get back soon. With that, we'll get started here. I hope you'll bear with me. They gave me a lot of time to talk, so I'm going to use that at least that much. We'll begin by thanking everyone at RJ Reynolds and Andy for the, this is just an incredible amount of money. You know, to receive this kind of money for something that I love to do is just incredible. And that makes my first check of $35 seem rather insignificant. But I know on that night in 1977, the $35 and ninth place finish in my first race seemed like the greatest accomplishment in the world to me and my friends, Andy Petrie and Jimmy Newsom, who are both here tonight. As the saying goes, good things come to those who wait. Andy Schindler, a big thanks to you and many others at RJ Reynolds Tobacco Company. Over the years, you have played a huge part in making NASCAR Winston Cup Racing the most successful form of motorsports in the world. It has taken many people countless hours of hard work and millions of dollars to achieve this success. I would personally like to thank you for making tonight and the experiences Kelly and I, along with our entire Robert Yates Racing organization, have had this past week possible. It has been a great year and week in New York City that we will never forget. And also, thanks in advance for your continued support. I spent many hours thinking about where to start tonight, and what better place than at the top. I would like to thank God for the many blessings He has bestowed upon me and our race team. He deserves the thanks for the many talents that He brought together as one at Robert Yates Racing. There have been many difficult decisions to make and hurdles to jump in my life and career. I know my faith and following God's answers to my prayers are the reasons I've been blessed in all aspects of my life. Thanks to Max Helton, Dick Mason, and the entire MRO staff for their help and guidance in my life and those in the NASCAR community. They have helped shape and guide many of us in this sport. They have provided our children with a wonderful Christian atmosphere in which to grow up in, and we certainly appreciate it. Family is extremely important to me, and I'm honored and fortunate to say that I view mine as the true champions. They have supported me through the best and worst of times. Mom and Dad, thanks for your many years of guidance and support. Your willingness to help others and the examples you set forth of being leaders is what make me and our entire family very proud. Dad, I didn't know when I got involved in this sport if I could ever achieve any of the great accomplishments you did. But it is truly an honor to be on this second father-son duo to win a NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. Thanks for everything. Many thanks go to my sister Patty and my brother Glenn. Their support has been tremendous. Now for Glenn, that's been fairly easy since I pay him well, and he knows if I have a few spare hours, I'll be calling him to play golf. Patty, on the other hand, is in a very peculiar position. As many of you know, Patty's husband is Jimmy Maycar, crew chief and team manager at Joe Gibbs Racing. She does a tremendous job of balancing the two roles of supporting my career along with that of her husband's. Thank you. To my four children, Jason, Natalie, Carson, and Zachary, I know I can never make up for the many times I've had to be away, miss the many important things in your life because I was off chasing my dream. But I thank you for being here and sharing this special night with all of us. I can't say thank you enough, and I love each one of you very much. Actually, I think Zach was more excited about coming to New York because one of his favorite movies, Home Alone 2, was filmed here. Is that right, Zach? Now to the tough part. I hope I get through this. Rusty, I'm trying hard, man. You told me to keep it together up here, and I'm trying. To the most important person in my life, you have all probably heard that behind every successful man, there's a great woman. For Dale Jarrett, there couldn't be a truer statement. My best friend and wife, Kelly, has been through every single minute of my racing career. We've laughed, shed tears, and celebrated together. She has supported me all throughout my career, and I do mean that literally in the early years of our marriage. She tells me when I'm right, and oh yes, when I'm wrong. She helps make all of our business decisions, and yet somehow, she finds the time to do the things she loves to do the most, be a great wife and the best mother our children could possibly have. To know Kelly is to know how much her family means to her. It's that sense of family value that makes Kelly the loving and caring person she is. Thanks for staying with me on this roller coaster ride to the top. I certainly couldn't, nor would I have wanted to do this without you. I love you always, honey. Some of Kelly's family and a few of our other friends made the trip up to help us celebrate tonight, and my many thanks go to each of you. On the subject of families, it is this time I would like to thank the France family. The many opportunities you have made available to all of us are countless. Over the years, you have become a family known throughout the business and sports arenas. To Bill, Betty Jane, Jim, Brian, Lisa, and your entire organization, thank you for continuing to build and develop a sport that we are proud to be a part of. The competition in NASCAR Winston Cup Racing has never been closer due to the efforts of many people led by Mike Helton, Kevin Triplett, and Gary Nelson. Thanks to you and your group of professional officials for your cooperation in handling many difficult situations. We know your job can be, at times, a thankless one, but we all appreciate everything you do. Many thanks to the racetracks for providing the competitors and our families with great facilities. In a sport where the travel can be very tiring and difficult, your continued efforts to improve and grow to help accommodate our families and fans are greatly appreciated. A critical and vital part of this explosion of NASCAR Winston Cup Racing is due in part to our loyal fans. Whether you're a fan of Dale Earnhardt, Jeff Gordon, Bobby Labonte, or for that matter, any of our talented drivers, I know I can speak on behalf of all the drivers that our jobs wouldn't be complete without your intense support. Thank you for your contribution in making our sport the number one spectator sport in America. Since that fateful night 23 years ago in 1977, when I competed in my first race, there have been many people that have helped me get to this point. Please understand that I don't have the time to name everyone. Of course, I would love to do so. But I would like to thank a few of those that have been instrumental in making this championship a reality. Andy Petrie, a proud car owner of two NASCAR Winston Cup teams, and Jimmy Newsom, owner of a successful tire business in Newton, North Carolina, are the people responsible for giving me my first chance to drive. Thanks, guys, for taking the chance and giving me the opportunity. There have been many hardworking volunteers who logged countless hours over the years, and I thank each of you from the bottom of my heart. But some key names to mention through my Busch Grand National years are Horace Eisenhower, Jerry Punch, Junior Setzer, Carlos Johnson, John Irvin, Rick Bowman, Kenny Canup, Tim Sigmund, and Mark Shook. Thanks to each of you. Others that have made a significant impact in my racing career are Kell Yarborough, Hoss Ellington, Jimmy Makar, and Joe Gibbs. Joe, you not only made a difference for me in racing, but in my spiritual life as well. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate Jimmy, Bobby Labonte, and Joe Gibbs on a fantastic season. You and your organization are a class act. In 1990, the biggest opportunity of my NASCAR Winston Cup career came from the Wood brothers. Am I ever glad that I answered the phone that day Eddie Wood called? It was the opportunity that brought me my first Winston Cup victory in 1991. This team, especially Eddie and Carol Wood, remain some of our closest friends. Thanks to each of you for your friendship and support. There have been numerous others, car owners, crew members, and drivers, that have been there for me on several occasions. I admire and respect each driver for helping build this sport to the enormous entity it is today. I specifically want to mention three men I admired for years in this sport. Richard Petty, for just being the king. Darrell Waltrip, for your ability to win while caring for others, not to mention your great wit. And lastly, the guy a lot of you know as the Intimidator, Dale Earnhardt. Thanks for being a true champion and a really good friend to me during the times when I needed my friends the most. Thanks, buddy. Along with friends, family, and dedicated employees, it takes a lot of financial support to mold and maintain a championship-caliber race team. Now, I'm sorry I don't have a rhyme or a story this year, and I sure can't sing, even though I may try a little later at our party. Anyway, I want to acknowledge each of the companies that helped take our team from being a vision to the top of our sport. I realize most of you know our sponsors, but this is a big night, and we're indebted to them for their support. So thanks to Ford Motor Company, Ford Quality Care Service, Ford Credit, Coca-Cola, Fleetwood RVs, Motorcraft Parts, Plastico Paints, Mac Tools, Nike, Texaco, Planters Peanuts, Bollé Sunglasses, which is what I wear. The team, as you heard Rusty say, wears Oakley's, so thanks to them for supplying the gas. Outback Steakhouse and Action Performance Companies. Thanks to each one of you. Well, I am the fortunate one whose name is on this trophy, and I'm the lucky representative of Robert Yates Racing that has enjoyed this week the most. I would not be standing before you if not for the hard work and dedication of each and every one of you 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship team members. You guys are the very best. We have one more round of applause for these people that really have made all of this possible. This is a team sport more now than ever. And this year, you are at the head of the class, guys. Your never give up attitude that everyone has talked about and relentless desire to be the very best are why we are here to salute each of you as champions. I would like to thank you, thank your families for their understanding and sacrifices to allow you the time to be the very best. You all are very special, and now the world knows what I've known for 5 years, that everyone at Robert Yates Racing is a champion. Enjoy your time in the limelight, but let's stay focused on trying to win another championship next year. Thanks and congratulations to all of you. It takes a special group of leaders to know and place these people in their proper positions, to run the day-to-day operations, and to spend those sponsorship dollars wisely. We have three of the best running our organization. Doug Yates, our 1999 Engine Builder of the Year, heads up what many consider, including myself, to be the premier engine business in racing. When we sat down at the end of 1998 and decided what we needed to do to win a championship, Doug added a few more talented people to his already incredible staff. Their goal was to have the most horsepower every week without giving up reliability. That's a very difficult combination to produce, but that's exactly what we had all year. No failures and great power. To everyone in the engine shop, thanks for a job well done. Todd Parrott. Todd, not only are you our crew chief, but our dedicated leader by example. And what do I mean by this? What I mean is that Todd demands a lot from his people, doing whatever it may take to win. In many cases, this requires working extra hours. But Todd never asks any of his guys to do something he doesn't also do. He's a true leader that has gained the respect of many. Now, Todd and I have worked together for 4 fantastic years. However, we have been friends much longer than that. I believe our friendship is so deep because of our desire and determination to win every week. Those two things have truly made our relationship what it is today, Todd. I know many people only see the very determined and focused side of Todd Parrott, but I'm lucky to see your other side, the caring and soft-hearted husband and father you are to your family. Thanks for all the things you are to each of us, for making us champions, but most of all, thanks for being my friend. You're the best, buddy. Now, I'd ask you to please indulge me for a few more moments as I near the end. I promise we're getting close. The people I work for, Robert, Carolyn, and Richard Yates, are certainly what make my job the very best. They not only provide me with winning race cars, but they treat me and my family just like we are a part of theirs. Robert and Carolyn, thanks for the opportunities you have afforded me over these last 5 years. You've probably heard either Todd or myself say over the past couple of weeks how much we really wanted to win this championship for Robert. I can promise you there's no one more deserving or appreciative of this championship than Robert Yates. He is the type of owner every driver should have the opportunity to work with. In his 31 years in this sport, he has done every possible job. We all know him as the premier engine builder the sport has ever seen. But even today, you can find him at the race shop, working on engines, sweeping floors, and yes, even answering the phones sometimes. Robert is a man who could have very easily given up on this sport on any number of occasions. While he has enjoyed the spoils of victory, he has endured the pain of losing. The losses on the track cannot compare to the loss of a young man that was more like his son. Davey Allison will always be a big part of Robert Yates Racing. His hard work and fierce competitive spirit for the sport he loved helped make Robert Yates Racing the winning team it is today. Robert kept everything together after Davey's untimely death, and then, with the help of a determined Ernie Irvin, they too went on the chase for that elusive championship. In that battle in 1994, Robert Yates Racing was met once again with tragedy. Ernie was seriously injured in an accident in Michigan, and this was almost more than the team could handle. Once again, Robert and his team pulled together and persevered. Ernie would recover, and he and I would become teammates and friends. Thanks, Ernie, for your help and friendship and contribution to NASCAR racing. I believe you will agree with me that Robert has earned the honor to be the owner of the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship team. Congratulations, Robert and Carolyn. In closing, I would have to say that 1999 has been an incredible year in my life for many reasons, and here are just a few. I was able to attend a Dallas Mavericks basketball game earlier this year and receive a team jersey from those guys. I was able to throw out the first pitch at Tiger Stadium in Detroit, meeting Tour de France winner Lance Armstrong, who is a true inspiration to everyone, playing golf with a true legend, Arnold Palmer, and oh yes, winning my second Brickyard 400, but most of all, winning this NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. Here comes the tough part. Back in August, Kelly gave me a CD by Edwin McLean with a very special song on it that tells how we both feel right now. Now, I said earlier tonight I wouldn't sing, and I promise I won't, but I would like to read a few of the lyrics, and they go like this. I could not ask for more than this time together. I could not ask for more than this time with you. Every prayer has been answered. Every dream I have come true. And right here in this moment is right where I'm meant to be, here with you, here with me. These are the moments I thank God that I'm alive. These are the moments I remember all my life. I've got all I've waited for. And I could not ask for more. God bless you and Merry Christmas.
Up until tonight, only one other father-son duo have claimed the title of NASCAR Winston Cup Series champions. As this year's champion takes his seat, it's a pleasure to introduce a fellow ESPN broadcaster, two-time NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion, Mr. Ned Jarrett.
Thank you, Dale, for making us so proud. You know, things have changed a little bit since I won championships back in 1961 and 1965. They were held at the Princess Athena Hotel in Daytona Beach, Florida. NASCAR, some of you, I can see, are old enough to remember that. NASCAR would honor all of their champions all of their divisions, same night. And it was in a room that maybe would hold 100 people. And my first check in 1961 for winning the championship was a little over $6,000. When I won it again in 1965, inflation had set in, I guess, and the check was a little over $8,000. How much was that check you got here tonight? Boy, how things have changed. Of course, we didn't have Winston as a sponsor back then. But one thing that we did have was the France family. Much has been said about them tonight here. And they built NASCAR on family values, and thank you for that. And we're just proud that the Jarrett family can continue some of that family tradition that has been established in our sport over the years. We're extremely proud to be in a category of Richard and Lee Petty as the only father and son combinations to have won NASCAR Winston Cup championships. And Dale, with your faithful and untiring trust in God, your desire to help other people, and your love for your family makes Martha and I very proud for what you've accomplished this year. Thank you so much for keeping the Jarrett family name, alive in the sport of auto racing. We appreciate you so much. Congratulations, Robert, Todd, Doug, the whole crew, all of you guys up there for a fantastic year, and certainly making a pleasure for us. Thank you very much.
A very special night for a very special family. Dale Jarrett is NASCAR's newest Winston Cup champion. We'll hear from him when we come back.
The 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards Banquet has been brought to you by The Home Depot. The Home Depot would like to congratulate Tony Stewart, 1999 NASCAR Rookie of the Year, by Zales, the Diamond Store, and by Pennzoil with Pure Base, made for the way you drive. Stop, go, Pennzoil.
And just a reminder, SportsCenter coming up next with Bill Pito and Linda Cohn. Blazers Lakers highlights, a question of the night, take your best shot. And to bowl or not to bowl? The question being answered in the Mid-American Conference between Marshall and Western Michigan. Well, Benny Parsons, the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards Banquet is history, and there were some special moments people didn't get to see, including Brian France, the senior NASCAR vice president, introducing Edsel Ford, who spoke emotionally about his hero, Jackie Stewart, and how the heroes of today's youth won Dale Jarrett. Sam Jabara, chairman for Goodyear, presented a 24-karat gold replica of Dale Jarrett's quality car, Taurus, and of course, NASCAR president Bill France with the diamond ring presentation. Benny, what a night.
It was a terrific night, $2.9 million. Dale Jarrett, what are you gonna do with all that money?
Well, let's find out. Dale, tonight you've been praised by your competitors, by your family, and your friends. A million miles from Hickory, North Carolina tonight, and about $3 million away too. Congratulations.
Just incredible. I think that's what made getting up and having to talk after hearing everything that a lot of people had to say. That's very gratifying and satisfying, and I think it's always what your peers and competitors have to say about you that means the most to me. And just an incredible night. I hate it's over, but we certainly look forward to representing this sport as their champions.
Well, this part of it's over. You've got a long night ahead of you hosting some of your friends and family and a new year to look forward to in the year 2000.
Yeah, we've got a nice party. A lot of my friends and family are here, so we're going to have a good time with the Commodores playing. So we're excited about that. Looking to 2000, now's the time to start. This part of it is over, and you know, probably the hardest thing we're going to have to do is try to win a second championship.
Well, we look forward to you leading this sport into 2000. Once again, congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thanks to all the fans.
Dale Jarrett, the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup champion. Jerry.
And Bill Weber, some final thoughts and one final look back at the highlights of the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup season. Well, the 51st edition, the 1999 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards Banquet from the Grand Ballroom of the Waldorf Astoria in New York City is history. And Benny, reflect if you would on your final thoughts on what this incredible year this has been.
You know, Dale Jarrett last year at this banquet was the highlight of the banquet. His speech was humorous, very, very humorous. And tonight, Bobby Labonte's speech was humorous. But both those guys, their speeches were in losing situations. Tonight, Dale Jarrett's speech was not humorous. It was very, very serious because he really had to thank all those people that have been so instrumental in helping me get here.
And you know, there was a lot of people being thanked tonight, or a lot of cash being given out, but one thing I want to do is I would like to thank you, the race fans, for allowing us to come into your living rooms on so many Sunday afternoons and be a part of your family. For that, we will be forever grateful. You know, as the holiday season approaches, I'd like to encourage you to pause for just a moment and count your blessings. And also remember those that are less fortunate. Legendary basketball coach John Wooden once said, "You cannot live a perfect day without doing something for someone who can never repay you." We leave you with that thought and a look at the sights and sounds of what was the final NASCAR Winston Cup Series season of the century. So long, everyone.
Presentation of ESPN. Proud to celebrate another moment from our first 20 years. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network. Go.com. ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
Here is the king out of the car.